Hello everyone, I am Mr. Chirag. I would like to welcome you all for a subject introductory video on pump, compressor and fan. This is a departmental level elective. Now, as the name stands, pump, compressor, fan, additional to it, we are going to see one more mechanical device which is a blower in this particular subject. Now, what do you understand by the word pump? Every one of you as an engineer is aware of a mechanical device which is nothing but a pump. So pump is a device which is used to transport or move liquid through pipe and channel. Now let me make this in a more simpler way. For example, your municipal corporation supplies you water in the tank at the ground level. So it is stored in the tank at the ground level. Then in a building, it is generally seen that there is a pump which is attached, which takes in water from this particular tank at the bottom level and supplies it to the tank at the top level. Now this tank at the top level supplies water to all particular individual homes which are situated in that particular building. So here we can see the exact application of the pump, that is, it is taking water at the lower level and it is displacing water at some higher level. So this is a basic use of a pump that I have talked about in this particular video. In industries, pump has a vast application. For example, it is used to transport fluid from one place to another place. Or even in chemical industries, a chemical has to be transferred from one place to another place. So this was about the pump. Now let's move ahead. Compressor, blower and fan. You may have studied compressor in your third semester in thermodynamics. That was an air compressor. What does a compressor does? A compressor does nothing but it compresses the air. Now, what do you understand by the compression of air? That is, the pressure of the air is increased. Okay, the molecular distance between the molecules is decreased. What you have studied in your third semester was nothing but a air compressor because the fluid was air. Over here, we are going to see a general compressor which can be used to compress any gas. Okay, the types of compressor, you already have studied reciprocating compressor, so we won't be touching on to that. We will be going on to centrifugal compressor and axial compressor, which are other types of compressors. Now moving ahead, this particular device that you can see in the picture over here, every one of you may be aware of this particular device. You may have seen it at your puncture repair center, okay, where you generally take your automobile when there is a puncture. So this particular, even in your heat transfer lab, this particular instrument is available. So what it does, it compresses the air. Okay, that compressed air is stored in this particular tank, and then we use it whenever required. Now this particular photo over here is nothing but your small fan. Now the question arises, what is the difference between a compressor, blower and fan? So all three devices are used to move gas or compress gas. Now, when it comes to a technical specification, a fan can increase pressure up, a device is said to be fan if it increases pressure up to 1.11. That is, if output pressure is 1.11 times the input pressure, then we say it is a fan. If it is almost 1.11 to 1.2, we say it is a blower. And the third thing is compressor, where the compression ratio is comparatively higher, that is above 1.2. So all these three devices are works in on a similar principle, that is, a pressure at output is higher than the pressure at the input, and that is how there is a movement or there is a flow of a fluid. Now this particular thing, that is a pump, compressor, fan and blower, that is what we are going to study in this particular subject. So the question arises, why should I study PCF? The answer to this particular question is, as you will be a mechanical engineer in the upcoming year, you have already done your engineering 75%, 25% engineering is still remaining, that is, you are in the final year. Now as a mechanical engineer, you should be in the position to select suitable design or analyze a performance of a pump. Pump is extensively used in a mechanical industry. You should be able to analyze the performance of a pump. Okay, next, you should be able to demonstrate, design and analysis compressor, fan and blower. Now this compressor, fan and blower, in my next videos I will be talking where does it has a particular application. Okay, so as an engineer, if you want to analyze pump or if you want to analyze compressor, this particular subject will be very much important in order to understand or understand the concepts behind those particular mechanical devices. Now coming to the applications, so these particular devices that are mechanical utility systems have application in wide variety of industry. As I mentioned, some of them, that is say aerospace, automotive, chemical, electronics, food, beverage. You take any of the core mechanical industry and you will find one of these particular devices, that is pump, compressor, fan, blower over there. Okay, none of the mechanical industry can survive, core mechanical industry can survive without these particular mechanical utility systems. So Widers have added a word, career opportunity. When you pass out as a BE graduate, when you join an industry, you will be looking at these particular devices over there. Now, if you have already studied what is the basic behind those particular thing, it would be easier for you to get gel up with that particular industry in order to understand their system, and that would be an additional advantage. So all the industries which are mentioned over here, apart from it, if you take any of the core industry, you will be looking at these particular devices. Even in your HVAC, there is a blower in a ducting system. Your cold air has to be displaced from one place to another place. So in your ducting system, we have to put a blower over there. Moving ahead, as I already said, it is very important that these are the mechanical devices used across various industry, without which functionality of mechanical industry is impossible. Okay, so if you study this subject, you will be in a better position to understand these particular utility systems, and that will give you an additional edge when you are placed in certain industry. Now, moving on to actual course contained in this particular subject. So the first module will be the introduction to the fluid machinery, that is pump, compressor, fan and blower. Now, the second module is reciprocating pump and centrifugal pump that we are going to talk about. That are two types of pumps. Then we are going to see design and analysis of those particular pumps, that is reciprocating as well as centrifugal. Then we are going to see what is introduction of fan, blowers and compressor. What are those particular things? How do we differentiate? What are their characteristics? We are again going to see design and analysis of those particular things. And at the end, we are going to talk about compressor, that is in module number 5, we are going to talk about fan and blower, and in module number 6, we are going to talk about compressor. As I said, you have already studied reciprocating air compressor. Over here, we are going to go on to axial compressor and centrifugal compressor. Now, this was the overview about the subject. When it comes to actual examination, the paper pattern, that is out of 120 marks, where 6 questions each carry 20 marks. So the theory is about 70 to 80 marks, that is the 60% of the paper. The numericals are about 40 to 50%. Now, I would like to make a note over here that generally students tend to have a tendency that the theory subjects are somewhat simple in order to understand as well as to write the paper. But when it comes to scoring good marks in your theory paper, it is very difficult to get a good score. I mean, you can get about your 60%, 70% score, that is quite, but you won't go about 95%, 90%. Okay, when it comes to a competitiveness, you have to attempt for the numericals, because in numericals you can get say 40 out of 40, 50 out of 50, so that gives you additional edge. In numericals, if you have solved it in a correct way, there is no way that examiner is going to evaluate it and he has to reduce the marks. But when it comes to theory, many a times it is seen that he is disappointed what a person has written, and he generally doesn't give the entire score. So in order to get the best score in your end semester exam, this particular combination can be very useful. That is, on the one side, you are safe saying that you can get the passing marks very easily. On the other hand, even you can score good marks. So moving ahead, so this particular subject is for final year mechanical engineering student, that is a 7th semester departmental elective subject. And as this is a core thermal subject, what requirements a student needs to have is he needs to have basic knowledge of thermodynamics, fluid mechanics and heat transfer. A very basic knowledge like on thermodynamics, which can be helpful in order to relate the things when he learns this particular subject. Okay, so if you have a good basics in these particular three subjects, it will give you a better, you will be in a better position, and that will be an additional benefit when you learn this particular subject. So that was about the subject. Now you can go through my bio data. If there are any questions on this particular topic about the departmental level elective that I am going to teach, that is PCF, you can mail me at chirag@sjcm.edu.in. You can even WhatsApp me. You can call me. I am ready to rectify your issues or any doubts that you will be having in this particular subject. Okay. I hope you understand what is the content of the subject, how it will be beneficial for you in your future. Thank you one and all. Have a nice day.